Hello friends, my name is Bindi Patel. Today we are going to discuss about hospice care. Okay? So what is hospice care? The word hospice comes from the Latin word hospitem. The meaning of hospitem is guest house. Now hospice care is designed to give supporting care to the people in the final phase of a terminal illness and focus on the comfort and quality of life rather than cure. Okay, so in the hospice care, there is no curing to the patient. There is a symptomatic and supportive treatment given to the patient. Okay, in their terminal illness, when patient's life expectancy is only 6 months or less than 6 months, then it is called the terminal illness. And in this case, we are giving the hospice care to the patient. Now, what is the definition of hospice care? Hospice care provides medical services, emotional support, and spiritual resources for people who are in the last stage of a terminal illness, such as cancer or heart failure. Okay, so this, when the cancer, last 3 or 4 stage of the cancer is there, then there are zero survival rate is there. A patient is having only some time, like 6 months or less than 6 months, then it is called terminal illness. Okay, same here in the heart failure. So, hospice care also helps family members for manage the practical details and emotional challenge of caring for a dying loved one. Okay, so hospice care is not only given to the patient, it is also given to their family members also, because they are losing their loved one. So, how to cope up with this situation and how to cope up with this mental state, they are helping to the family members also. Now, what is the goal of hospice care? The goal is to enable the patient to be comfortable and free of pain so that they live each day as fully as possible. So, they are relieving the pain. Okay, so the patient can live comfortably to their remaining life. Hospice program offers services 24 hours in a day, 7 days in a week in your own home or in a hospice center. So, hospice services are available 24/7 in a patient own home only or to the hospice center. Okay, some hospice care also offer services in nursing home, long term care facility, or in the hospital also. Now, what is the philosophy of hospice care? To provide support for the patient's emotional, social, spiritual need as well as medical symptoms as a part of treating the whole person. So here we are giving the comprehensive care to the patient. Okay, not only one care, we are giving the physical care also, emotional care also, social care also, spiritual care also. So these all kind of the care we are providing to the patient under the hospice care program. Now, aggressive method of pain control may be used. Means here patient can be given the steroids also to relieve the patient's pain, because here the comfort of patient is most important. Then hospice programs generally are home based, but they sometimes provide services away from home in the freestanding facilities or in the nursing homes or within the hospital house. Now, what is the history behind the hospice care? So, the concept of hospice as an holistic interdisciplinary approach to end of life care began in Great Britain during the 1960s. The Medicare hospice benefit was passed in the United States in 1982 and has served as the basis of the hospice model of care in the US and as a model for Medicaid and private insurance provision and reimbursement. So, the first hospice care model started in 1982 in the United States. So, what are the eligible criteria for comes under the hospice program? So, patient's condition should be terminal illness, means it should be not curable. Okay, then only it can consider as a comes under the hospice care program. Your doctor has indicated that your life expectancy is 6 months or less than 6 months if your illness runs its normal course. Usually a form must be signed by your primary doctor as well as a medical director or physician member of a hospice team. So hospice team will assess the patient's condition and then only they will decide that patient will be comes under the hospice program or not. then what kind of service provided? So hospice service generally include basic medical care with focus on pain and symptomatic treatment, then medical supply and equipment as per needed. Okay? For example, gloves, urinary catheter, IV line, IV cannula, diapers, all these things. Counseling and social support to help you and your family with psychological, emotional and physical issues. And guidance with the digital but normal issues of life completion and closure. Okay, you can imagine when patient know that I am going to die within a 6 months or patient family member condition that we are going to get our loved ones lost. Okay, so this kind of the situation is very critical for the patient and their family members. So this is the time when they need highly emotional support. Okay. Then a break, a respite care for caregiver, family and others who regularly care for the patient. Volunteer support such as meal preparation or errand running. Counseling and support for loved ones after they die. Okay, so when patient is dying, after that also they need support. Not only during the patient is there in the under the hospice care. Okay. Now hospice service. So service provided by hospice have been defined by the Medicare hospice benefit and are the same whether hospice care is covered by Medicare, Medicaid, private insurance or charity. Okay. So they include nursing services. All nursing services given to the patient and physician participation. What kind of the medication should be given, what kind of the pain reliever should be given, and counseling services, okay, to cope up with their mental situation and spiritual support to live their remaining life healthily and happily. And inpatient care, all the care we are getting in the hospital, all the same care we are giving to the patient in their home only. And home health care service, like we are helping the patient in their routine life, daily activities, for example, brushing, bathing, wearing the clothes, removing the clothes, having food. So these all kind of the help we are getting in the under the home health aid service. And giving medication, medical equipment, laboratory and other diagnostic studies also be given. Then therapies as appropriate, which may be include physical therapy, occupational therapy, speech therapy. So all these kind of the therapy is given under the hospice program. And respite care. Okay, so respite care in this, they are helping the family members and the caregivers who are giving the care to the patient. Okay? And bereavement support. Where after the dying of the patient, they are helping the family members to cope up with this emotional situation. Okay? So this is all about the hospice services. Thank you. Here we are concluding our topic. Stay home and stay safe. Bye.